Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I take great pleasure in welcoming all of you to the launch of this new series. I have called it the Thinking Cap. Well, I'll talk about the Thinking Cap a little later. We want to begin with a tribute to, we have the researcher, scholar, dancer, academic, Sri S. Jayachandran with us today. He has been conducting his research under a legendary academician, Dr. Navjyoti Singh, who unfortunately passed away around a week back. And many of the members, the distinguished members we have with us today, have worked very closely with Navjyoti Sir, as they call him. So Jayachandran wanted to begin the evening with a tribute to him. He will tell you more about Navjyoti Sir and this whole concept of the nine lamps and everything else. So I call upon Jayachandran Garu to introduce this tribute.
Consideration that wisdom has always been celebrated in larger cultures in India like this. Professor Navjyoti has been one of the greatest thinkers we have ever known in the current. Many people have contributed to our wisdom stream. I am one of the students. My colleague Sunil here, who won't handle laptop today, he is another research student. Dr. Saroja, she is another research student doing her postdoc under we are still doing. That's why we are saying we are continuing or something. We will continue. And this is we don't want to call it a tribute or homage. Perhaps it's our work. We did our work together that he had a project called Radhya. Professor Navjyoti had this wonderful idea. Radha, as many people would understand, it is born out of Dhyan. Raga Dhyan. Henceforth, the Raga is born. There is something called Manana, fine. Generally, education starts with something called Manana, which nowadays modern urban people say no, not to memorize anything. But education essentially starts with Manana. Then it enters into something called Chinta, and later that metamorphosed into something called Dhyana. So, Navjyoti always used to say, a Raga is more a Dhyana. Which later in time, just for pedagogical reasons, someone writes Arohana and Avarohana for it. Raga can never be anything to do with Arohana and Avarohana, and it is only a pedagogical material. Henceforth, based on the project, one of the postdoc material what Dr. Saroja worked was on the Dhyan project, out of which perhaps we took some 1.5 years to evolve one Raga. Actually, it was a constant work, 1.5 years or something. And we named that, initially we named it something else, but later under his consent, we named it as Navjyoti. So, Dr. Saroja, along with her sister Sujatha, the TK sisters, would present Rag Navjyoti and a composition, what she created on it, and kind of vouchsafed by the musicians of the fraternity. Rag Navjyoti as a Dhyan.
So we named this Raga Navjyoti not to just give our professor's name to it, but it was also a new light, Navajyoti, to me personally and all of us, that we got to think of such a possibility. So it is named Navajyoti. So we'll present that now.
Sa da da sa da sa da pa ma ri ga pa da sa ri
Saw the invitation. You're calling it a cap and you put a turban. So, for us in our culture, the head gear has always been a symbol of a person's position in society, their knowledge stream, their level, the prowess and their skill have all been symbolized by the headgear that they wore on their head as a symbol of their, you know, the king would have a different kind, the scholar would have a different kind. So everyone had a different kind of thing and it symbolized some form of leadership and excellence in a particular stream or a particular discipline. So I have been thinking of the thinking cap for quite some time because I thought we have enough foray in the country for promotion of performance. Dance, music, they're all becoming very performance oriented. You know, everyone wants to wear a good costume and then go out there and dance, which is nice, nothing wrong with that. But in a milieu where arts are existing in a capsule, it's not part of our daily life. You know, you're doing so many other things and art, dance, music is just a small section of your life. Then somewhere we lose out on the vast repository of training which the traditional and the hereditary dancers had in their lifetime, because they learned the allied arts. They learned everything connected to their art and they became complete artists. So somewhere we are missing out on that, and if we don't have any forum to showcase research, then we completely miss that entire part of the learning system. So either, you know, it should, what I thought was either performing art or fine art or any form of art should either be experiential, something which you experience and do, or at least it should be informed, one of the two. So either we should appeal to the mind, heart, or we should appeal to the mind. So, you know, some via media we have to find. So I thought we'll start the thinking cap, so that every 3 months we can showcase artists, thinkers, academics, you know, people who have contributed immensely to the field of the arts through their research work. And this could be in any field connected to performing art or fine art. And I also plan to make this a traveling series where we go to other cities and take thinking cap there. Maybe present artists from other cities in other cities, so that you don't keep getting to see your own local artists, but you see people who are coming from across the country. So this is just a launch, and I'm very fortunate that I'm launching with such a wonderful presentation. Let me tell you something about this these wonderful academics and artists we have with us today. When I thought of launching the thinking cap, I was thinking, what should I do as the first presentation? Because I was pretty sure I don't want it to be me going out there and talking and dancing, because that we keep doing all the time anyway. So So when we were discussing these things with Jayachandran, we thought, you know, we'll come out with this presentation. And so I'm very honored that a scholar of the caliber of Jayachandran has consented to be the first presenter for Thinking Cap. With an electronics engineering background and having worked as a software person in Wipro, having started his career like that, Jayachandran then joined Kalakshetra as the head of research and documentation and went on to become an assistant professor there. And he has not less than 3 MAs. So he's an MA in history, he's an MA in philosophy, and an MA in Bharatanatyam as well. And he's an electronics engineer. So talk about striding different worlds. Trained under exemplary and legendary gurus like Meera Narayanan ji, Guru Gopinath, Leela Samson, C.V. Chandrasekhar sir, his wife Jaya Chandrasekhar ji, and the Abhinaya exponent Braga Bessel. So he has had a wide experience of the different aspects of Bharatanatyam. He has a diploma in Shaiva Siddhanta too. I mean, as if the MAs were not enough. So this presentation that you will see today on the Tiruvarur Sthalam was one that got him the best lecture demonstration in the Madras Music Academy, which is no mean feat. So I'm very honored, Jayachandran ji, that you have consented to be the launch pad of Thinking Cap. We have with us the two wonderful sisters here. They're known as the TK sisters, TK Saroja Garu and TK Sujatha Garu. One is a MSc in mathematics, the other is an MA in English. And both of them are masters in music from the Padmavati University. And she has also done her PhD. Saroja Garu has done her PhD from the Padmavati University. She is with IIIT right now. She's also a lecturer and she's working on a postdoc. And the most beautiful aspect is that both of them are trained under the legendary Sangeeta Sahitya Kalanidhi Guru C.H. Krishnamacharya Garu. They are direct disciples of this. And they have several programs to their credit. Well, I don't have to really tell you all that. Most of you are familiar with their work. We have nothing short of PhDs here. Even our Mridangist has just submitted his PhD thesis. And Rajashekar Garu is also a graded artist of All India Radio and quite a popular violinist. So we welcome you all to Thinking Cap. And I would start off Thinking Cap, but before I do that, I'll tell it right now. I don't want to interrupt. We have a wonderful dancer who's going to demonstrate along with JC. JC is what we call him. So she is trained in Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi for over 18 years, Vamsi Madhavi. She has trained under gurus like Rama Srikanji, CV sir, Chandrasekhar sir, and has graduated as a topper from the Kalakshetra Foundation. She has played lead roles of Sita, Rukmini in the dance dramas of Kalakshetra. She has performed extensively as a solo artist too and is now imparting training in Bharatanatyam to younger students. It's a very beautiful experiment that JC has tried, even with her costuming and everything. We are trying to bring the Tanjavur Devadasis alive in front of you today. So before I hand the mic over to JC, something which I must say, and I've always been saying from the time I started my research, for me no event is complete without the presence of somebody whom I call Master Garu, the legendary Sri Kamishetty Srinivasulu Garu, founder, director of the Annamacharya project, the inspiration behind M.S. Subbalakshmi composing those wonderful, you know, those immortal Annamacharya Kirtanas that we hear today. He is the one who has sat with her, told her the nuances. He is solely responsible for the propagation and the sustenance of the Annamacharya mission in the country. Solely responsible for it in his own, you know, very, very humble way. So thank you so much, Master Garu. So it's a great occasion for me. I have my guru's younger sister also here, Rajamanti, Kala Krishna Garu. Many other dancers are here. So I hand the mic over now to Sri S. Jayachandran to begin the launching presentation of the thinking cap, Tiruvarur Sthalam, and its interpretation in the compositions of Rukmini Devi. Welcome.